editing it, then getting it to the right format that you are able to upload it. And I think I stopped at uploading because I had no clue how to do that the last time I tried. Well, yeah.
I always
There's so
hate
much stuff.
these.
I'm
I
sorry.
always hate these this tournament stuff because the long delays. Because I'm used to no delay with my chat, so I'm used to like talking to people. And if you think about now that I'm using a minute delay, it's 2 minutes until I actually get a response to me saying something.
Yeah, it's sadly there's no other way to do it, otherwise teams would have an advantage.
Right. Okay, there. Now we're officially live. After the minute delay's up.
Yay. Hello. Well.
I'm waiting to see if YouTube picks it up, because sometimes YouTube just does not want to cooperate.
Well, you know, I can't even watch YouTube streams. Glorious Germany is not allowing YouTube to stream.
Yeah, I've actually heard people saying that.
Yes, it's, you know, Germans and their, I don't even know how to say it. It's just fucked up.
Strict restrictions.
There's like a little battle going on with something that's called GEMA in Germany, which is demanding itself to get paid if like someone is using music in a stream. And it's, well, yeah, they have a law battle going on in Germany with Google about stuff like that. Yeah.
I actually
They're
am
not
glad.
getting to.
Go ahead,
Yeah?
sorry.
Oh no, go ahead.
I was gonna say, I'm actually glad that I stream to YouTube, especially during these tournaments, because there's you'd be surprised how many people actually prefer to watch it on YouTube. It's
Well.
also because I'm not a Twitch partner, so they can't adjust the quality on mine, so I tell them to go to my YouTube response to me saying
Yeah.
something.
Meanwhile, filthy Germans have no chance to watch something via YouTube. And even Twitch, like. Direct clustering via Twitch is working with music in the background, but the second you want to go on past broadcasts, then you can almost say 100% when it's like a 1 hour video of a past broadcast, then there will be a well edited out audio tone in that video.
Yeah, like the last battle, which was yesterday's, there was 116 views on YouTube. So, you know,
Wow.
that's a whole that's a that was so I technically, including YouTube, I had about 400 people watching.
That's fun.
So, you know, they deserve to be able to watch it too. How's it going, everybody?
Hello. That's well from someone who's co-moderating today.
Place your bets, Wolfpack or 300 second.
For me, I have no clue.
I have no clue either. Oh, I need to tell Zebra to host me.
I think I once lost something against Wolfpack, so I know Wolfpack more than I know the 302nd. My bad is Wolfpack because I actually like have more knowledge about them.
I have no knowledge of any of these teams. Yeah, I did manage to call both matches yesterday, so I'm 2-0 for picking the winning team.
Well, okay then.
I'm gonna
I say
say,
Wolfpack. I'm saying Wolfpack.
what round are we on? I have no idea. I just stream what I'm told. I don't know much about what's
User
going on
joined
in
your
tournament
channel.
wise. Hey, Zebra, we're live.
Okay,
Hi,
guys,
Deborah.
can we have a short talk
Right, here.
without the viewers?
All right, sorry about that, guys. Yes, the mic was muted. We were having an officials talk. We might have a change of plans for this match. We might actually be doing a different match due to player counts. So just bear with us. We're still figuring that out. We'll know here soon. I need to switch to this. Yeah,
that's
we
unfortunate.
Might. What was that?
That's unfortunate right now.
Yeah, well, it's not for sure yet, but odds are we might have to be switching to a different match.
Yeah.
Which means I'll be having to edit some OBS settings on the fly, so you guys will get lots of black screens and such. Just watch me on YouTube. Thanks for watching me on YouTube. We might end up streaming the INVA versus Wiccanators match. But Zebra will let us know here in a moment, so just hold on for a sec. So who was it? Was it 302nd that was having player issues?
Yeah, they have, well, let's say as it is, they have three players right now that are on the TeamSpeak, and they're, well, not immediately able to get every player that is needed to get to the tournament right here, and, well, basically they're asking for a delay, because they, well, obviously want to fight, but they can't with three people. So they try to gather their stuff. They have a tough time now, and well, we'll see if they successfully get the people or not. That's the question right here.
Yeah, we're waiting to see if the 302nd can get more people on the TeamSpeak, because currently it's an uneven match. If they can't, we're going to have to probably postpone for like a half hour, and we'll be watching the INVA first Wiccanators match. Assuming that goes as planned. But it's in the air right now. We'll see what happens. NVA versus... Yeah, I'm not sure yet, so just... Yamagata, thanks for hosting. Latif, yeah, I didn't charge any points for gold when I did my personal stream.
Is that the fourth guy for the 302nd? Looks like it.
Maybe. They might be able to get their team together, hopefully. I hope they do, because I really don't want to start having to rush to make all these scenes for OBS.
Would mean more work for you then.
Well, I mean, it's like 5 minutes of work. The problem is that my screen will switch to black for the people, and then I'll be constantly adding stuff and editing the size, and this becomes a pain in the ass.
User joined your channel.
Okay, guys.
Hello, Zerba.
You're on the stream, right?
Yeah, yes. Do I need to mute it?
These guys will... they will play 4v4. The guys from 302nd have 4 people. They will have more soon, probably.
Okay.
And Wolfpack already. Yeah, we're waiting for the. I'm waiting for INVA to get 4 people. The guys from Wiccanators are already in my lobby.
Okay, so Are we streaming the 302nd match, or do I need to start making the other match
Well,
ready?
let me just check with them.
Okay.
User left your channel.
Yeah, you guys all should have been paid if I owed you any gold. We're still on the fence about the Wolfpack match.
Ah, convenient elevator music playing in the background.
Not on my end. I'm not doing it.
Well, that's what I listen to right now.
We already
it's
did our
fitting,
giveaway involuntary, and Stonehearth will be later on tonight. So, right now we're just waiting on our official to tell us what the game plan is. I'm just like checking my email. There's nothing I can do until he tells me what's going on for the match.
Yeah, I agree. I'm derping around as well.
I would love those.
Time I'm checking, like, if there's someone else joined for the 302nd. But in the meantime, I'm like browsing the interwebs.
Yes, we will be hosting a War Thunder channel once we figure out what the heck's going on. Because right now, everything's in the air. It's like, are we going to do the 302nd match? Are we going to do the Weakinators match? Are we just going to be waiting for a half hour? One of those three things is going to happen. And Darkest BR, did I have screen BRZ? I think they're on my... Let's see, what are they? Yeah, that's the next match. Well, DNW. Next match, that's the second match. Alright, see you in voluntary. Thanks for hanging out. I'm gonna change this. Waiting on 302nd players. May switch to. What the heck is the name? INVA versus. That needs to move. Oh, it's still too big. There. Now you guys know what's going on. I hope I spelled their names right.
User joined your
okay,
channel.
Cody.
Hey, what's up?
Let's go for INVA Vikinators first.
Okay.
You can come to my room. Here it is.
Alright, what's the details here?
While we wait. Yeah.
Ah, that was my daily restart. It was a good decision for me not to host the battle.
It's all your fault.
User left your channel.
Alright guys, we're going to be switching over to the INVA versus the Weakinators. I need to quickly make some scenes in OBS, so there's going to be a black screen, but I'm still here, the stream is not going down, just hold on. Okay, add image. Thanks for hosting War Thunder. Oh, you guys can't see me, never mind. Add game capture, War Thunder. Add. And once that, guys, we are quickly switching over to hold on, let me just make sure this is all working. We're switching over to the INVA versus Weakinators test. Test works. Okay, let me get my webcam up and running. Camera. 1280 by 720, 30 FPS. I'm huge. There. Add image. Overlay 1. NBA Rickinators. Add image. Overlay 2. We can use INVA. There we go. See, look at that. We're good to go. Sorry about that, guys. We had to switch over from the 302nd match due to lack of players. We'll be going back to that match later on tonight, I believe.
Till they eventually have enough players to do so?
Till they have enough people. Godhod, yes, there's an actual competitive scene to this game. It actually only took me about a minute to set up. A lot quicker than I thought it was going to be. I can pause all these previews. I'll just watch this one.
User left your channel.
Alright, who's leaving the channel?
That was Obelich.
Ah.
The Russian chief arbiter.
I thought you were abandoning me. Say, no, I need my German!
No, it's okay. I can't leave my position here.
Who do you think's gonna win? INVA or Weakinators?
That is a good question.
My follower sounds an A10 Warthog doing a gun run. I have to vote for INVA because a staff member is on the Weakinators, and I have to go against him. So I hope that INVA wins.
I know also that on the Weakinators, there's a German national community manager. So to avoid getting banned, I'm for Weakinators. Okay. It's a little cheeky explanation, but, well, I think also the Wikinators deserve to have a chance.
Nah, burn them down.
I want to see an envision, a nice battle and everything.
Hopefully it's a good fight. Hopefully there's no raffle stomps.
I don't believe so. I think they will give a good fight. But it's going to be it's going to be the 4v4, isn't it? So
yeah, I think so. I think this is a 4v4 because lack of players. But we need to stream some matches, so we'll take a 4v4.
Well, it's going to be something different from what the last streams were, then.
Yeah, it's a lot of different tactics. If there's only 4v4, you know, that's three allies, you're down.
Yeah.
I'll get you guys a link if you're curious about the D-Day combined battle tournament stuff.
So they're slowly joining the battle room.
What country flag is that? I have no idea. There you go. There's a Gladiator website for you guys to check out if you would like to.
I'm curious now.
That's just to the Gladiator Tournament section, it's not to that everything. Because I don't know exactly what people want to see. I'm talking crap to Super Mario right now in the game. So
I think I found it. No. Or yes?
This is RB,
sure.
Guys.
I think it's the flag of Mozambique.
Mozambique? Oh, okay.
I think so. It looks like it. Yes. I'm convinced it's the flag of Mozambique.
Okay.
Whoever is from Mozambique and that Vicky team. Probably no one.
They probably just randomly chose a flag. If I was to make one, I would go for the Scottish flag just for the heck of it. I'm like, no UK flag, it must be a Scottish flag. Actually, let's see. Let's see, they got a German, American, British person. Yep, nobody from Africa. Looking to see if anybody in TeamSpeak has that flag. All right, well, everyone, make sure that you pick a team. Try to hope that they win. I'm hoping for INVA two reasons. One, America. And two, because we have a staff member on the Weakinators, and I have to go against him. I have to make sure he fails.
Well, the INVA guys now joined the battle. At least three of them. Think we're not too far from starting.
Yeah, I think we're about to start here any moment. Actually, let me get a text up real quick. The match will begin in a couple minutes. Yeah, do you see what me and Super Mario are talking about in my game chat?
Yes. You guys have some fun there.
It's fun to be staff members. You can harass each other.
And yes, no, INVA is there.
Oh, apparently there's a member of the 302nd in my Twitch chat. He says, "My apologies that 302nd isn't ready. Entirely on me being stuck in traffic." Well, I mean,
Well, it's no problem as long as you manage to fight the battle.
no, I mean, Sparta, this is there is one staff member in this. He's a wiki editor and tech mod, but no, anybody is able to sign up for these tournaments. I'm not doing it because I don't play well with others. I get too competitive. Oh, I should probably choose referee
Yeah, the
team already
referee
up.
mode.
I've just been sitting here just like, yeah, I'm ready.
I was about to say it. Then you realize yourself. That's fine.
Takes me a couple minutes, but I'll catch up.
Well, as it appears, the INVA guys are ready. Just a question of the Viginators are ready, and then we have a battle going on. Finally.
A fattle?
Battle. That's a great thing that I'm doing. I'm thinking and then I'm telling a sentence, and in my thought, I'm already in the other sentence,
We can
probably.
start now. Our Lord and Savior Coco has arrived. Hi, Coco. People love my dog. I swear, if I ever had the money, I would get like a second camera and just have it on my dog and just call it the Coco Cam. I don't know if there is any simulator tournaments. I'm sure there must be. Or that maybe they will be if there's enough people wanting it.
For the last tournament, for the 7 versus 7 Blitz tournament, there was a simulator part.
Oh, there you go.
Was quite successful. The team that I'm in, we fought there as well. Well, it's you can say it's not that like fast as like realistic is, at least like Air Force wise, because well, cockpit view only and that kind of stuff, and there's not that much team signing up for it, but it's still like fun. It's just a question if the organizers are convinced that there's enough teams that are
I don't speak
interested.
Brazilian, sorry. I speak American, English, and Pig Latin. A little bit of German, a little bit of French, a little bit of Spanish. A Okay, the match is about to begin, ladies and gentlemen. It looks like it's gonna be a 5-on-5 match, actually. Not a
Oh, they
four versus
gathered
four.
another one. Nice. That's great. The more people, the better the battle itself will be.
Yeah, Valkyrie, your guys' match is on hold for a half hour, so you guys are fine.
Oh, what have I done on my two streak?
Whoa.
Yeah, I'm waiting to hope they begin soon. Looks like everybody's ready. I think they're okay. INVA is good. Wiccanators is good. Looks like the match is about to go underway.
And yes, we are starting. Right.
Right, let's get this show on
Whoa.
the road.
That's even a 5 versus 5. I mean, could have been, well, 7 versus 7, obviously, but given that this needed to be rushed, because the others were on, like, hold as they are right now. That's still fine.
Okay, I need to see what side is which. Coco, the match begins.
There we go.
There we go.
The Wiccanators rolling out with four tanks and one guy who is not spawned yet. And INVA going with two Jumbo Shermans, one M18, and two Corsairs. Oh, one with bombs.
One wiki guy still yet to spawn. Oh,
And
there he
he's going with
goes.
a BF109. Okay, no AAs.
We have one tank destroyer on the INVA team.
I'm curious if the NVA guys will take the advantage that there's no AA guarding the ground units from the Wiccanators and will directly attack with the rockets or the bombs. And as it appears, yes. The commander now going for the first bomb raid and
He wrecks, but he does get a kill.
that was a good trade-off. Not ideal for INVA, but certainly it's going to help them. Since, like, a dead tank is a dead tank.
That is true. But they did lose a valuable fighter.
That is true as well.
But even still, that was definitely their that was definitely better for the INVA than anything than the Weakenators.
They bring another M18.
Yeah, they've got a couple of M18s. Their M18 is trying to flank hard to the south, but the Weakenators are already there.
That is interesting. The Wiccanators are really flanking far south here in the battle with a Tiger and a Panther, which are going really, really far into the woods here. That is something that not a lot of teams are doing in this tournament, as like the main course of the battle is around the A cap and sometimes on the beach area. Not so much in like the
It is.
you can say forests on this map.
It is 3 minutes in, and nobody has captured an objective yet. This is the first time I've seen it during a tournament. Both teams are trying to maneuver instead of going headlong into an objective. But it looks
Now,
like here
the
comes a.
Wiccanator is doing a push on the A cap. What's the question? How INVA is reacting to that?
Oh, we're about to get some combat going on here at A. Freedom Launcher
Yes.
is not watching in front of him, and it's about to hurt him
Oh.
for it.
There we go, the first shot.
And he wrecks the jumbo.
Oh, there's an M19 on the side. And that was a solid shot into the gunner.
Gunner's out, not horizontal's damaged.
Not so not. And. No, the horizontal is still working. And he kept A.
Alright, Freedom Launcher is in a little bit of trouble here. He's got enemies behind him, flanking enemies in front of him. His gun is jammed. Almost
was
a, dead.
That was a one-hit on the M18 that was behind Freedom Launcher. Nice shot, friend. Feeds on your tears.
Looks like he's trying to repair now.
We'll use the backup to do so.
Looks
Feeds
like
on your tears is appearing like as if he is dismantling the second M18 as well. Yeah.
All three of the tanks are pretty badly damaged here. I'm gonna go look at the combat that's going on up at the hill.
Yep, that's the second M18 down.
We've got a Tiger and a Panther versus a Jumbo Sherman up at the hill. And the Jumbo's
down. Jumbo's
down. INVA is getting beat pretty badly right now. They could still come back though. I've seen them come back from worse.
I agree. Some of the battles. Oh,
he ricocheted off the MG port.
Yeah.
That demon did. He could shoot him through that archway. That people don't always remember that. There he goes. Gets a tranny shot.
Sadly, no like big damage there and. Oh, that's not good. He bounced as well. He's on your tears. They're like in a bounce duel right now. Never mind. No, he penetrated him.
Vehicle lost.
Now INVA coming in with crosshairs. Two of them, but without ground armament. They're just flying over the area.
I wonder if that was intentional or not.
That is quite, you can say, unusual. Normally people proceed to like spawn with normal ground armament.
Yeah,
if it was intentional, then it's questionable. If it wasn't, then that's not good for INVA in their attempt to win this round.
Got a little
round.
Bit of air combat going on now.
Super Mario did the same thing that he did in the first round. He tried to rocket kill the Corsair. Shot his rockets, missed them, or they better detonated in the air.
Who will win, Sergeant Bear or Super Mario? Kill Super Mario, please. He's a fellow staff member, gotta pick on him a little bit.
Now it's 2-1 here in the air. New Englander, Sergeant Bear against Super Mario.
A Super has a green wing.
And the problem for him is now that although his plane is a little faster than the F4U, the Corsair is the better turn fighter. So
plus he has
the
energy rocket
advantage.
He has a rocket tube still stuck to him too.
That's also.
He's getting shot.
2-1 in the air is just not possible for a single fighter when he's already in the defensive.
Looks like he ran out of speed here.
Yeah.
He's trying, but the Corsairs are just peppering him with 50 cal.
Let's see the damage on him.
He just lost the flap.
Yeah, he's going down.
On fire. Nosed over. He's out of there.
Meanwhile, on the ground, they lost their last tank. It's now
a spawn camping match.
Yeah, sadly, INVA is not able to do anything with the Corsairs now, since they don't have ground armament.
This is the first match, everybody.
So that's the first win for the Vikinators. Let's see how they do on the American side.
Got some friendly fire action going on here. Let's see, what are the F4Us doing? They're just flying. Yeah. Just Super Mile, looks like he brought only aircraft. He's bringing a Stuka. He's just dumping bombs and climbing. He knows match is done. And that is going to be game. First win to the Weakenators.
It was kind of strange to roll out with two FRUs without drone armament. I wonder what they thought when they've done it.
I think it was probably an accident on their behalf.
Well, from the position that the battle's normally rolling, it probably was.
You know, sometimes you accidentally click to battle and you forget to change your armament up from when you were playing like arcade or realistic or something, and you totally forget. I've done that a few times.
Yeah. Probably, yes. It's unfortunate, though. Could have brought them the win in this battle if the Corsairs had, like, rockets and they...
Well, the problem is the problem is that they just didn't have any ground units to use anymore. Yes, I'm a GM for War Thunder. For those of you guys who don't know, I'm Wiz25. I'm a GM for War Thunder. And joining me is an Arbiter for War Thunder, Cop Schrader. Is that how you say it?
It's right.
I'm trying to say it with a German accent.
It was fine. I mean, the first half is like cop, so
how did
I think
you come?
For the most people, how did you come with the name?
No, they were asking how do you check out BR on a PS4. I can't answer that. I don't use PS4, unfortunately. Yeah, we've actually got 2 to 3 matches we'll be streaming today. Our first match, we had to give it a half-hour delay due to lack of players on one of the teams.
That's still only 4 of the 302nd.
But I expect it to be still some good matches, good fights going on. Gotthold, I have no idea if that's the highest skill we're gonna have. We're halfway through the brackets right now or something? Hashtag go Mozambique. If IV or INVA wins this time, they continue on up the winner's bracket. If Weakenators...
I think it's the loser's bracket. That we see here.
Oh, I don't know. They go up the bracket. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I think it's the loser bracket, and they have the potential to get into the first place still, although they're in the loser bracket.
If Weakenators wins this, we go to our third tie. Our third match is our tiebreaker, which will be on Berlin, with both teams playing as American. Thanks for the follows, guys. Greatly appreciate it. Yeah, guys, feel free to chant for your favorite team. And if you're on the War Thunder channel, if you make
quickly
a chant...
Ready up.
Huh? Oh. I'm good. If you make a chant on the War Thunder chat, the best chant of the winning team will get 150 Golden Eagles.
Okay, there we go again.
I'm assuming it's going to be this.
I think with the Wiccanators on the American side this time, with INVA on the German side.
This is realistic battles, by the way, everybody, in case you're wondering. Realistic battles with name tags on. And yes, good, I guess you're right. Alright, looks like both teams are starting off with tanks, no AA guns. Oh, Super Mario bringing out the F4U.
Yeah, the Wikinator's bringing out one plane and four tanks on the ground. Meanwhile, IMVA bringing four tanks as well. Fifth guy is not spawned yet.
There, he's in the one line.
Ah, well, then we have similar tactics on this map now.
But he's bringing out the one line with the gun pods, so he's maybe going to try to knock out Super Mario and then try to kill any and all tank destroyers from America.
Super Mario trying to rocket attack, kills one.
Oh, nice. He killed a tiger.
Two pairs of rockets. That was a good kill. And gives the Wikinators a head start into the battle. Now he's approaching in a head-on.
His rockets miss. Both of them missed the head-on. Neither one connected.
The situation that Super Mario is in, and the fact that the VF-109 is the stronger plane in this lineup that the tournament provides, I would say that Super Mario is going to have a tough time against the 109. He already struggles to keep the altitude and speed that the 109 has.
I'm about to get some tank-on-tank combat right around this corner. Panther comes around the corner, immediately gets shot. He gets shot pretty hard. And he manages to return fire, nails a couple of crew on the enemy tank. That Panther is pretty messed up. His turret drive is gone. He's down a crew member.
And
he's down. Alright, let's see what.
Oh, INVA is spawned with a second plane. This time with rockets. Oh, and there goes Super Mario.
Very nice tactic by the Weakenators. They're mostly going for flanking, looks like. Whereas the INVA is going for an A rush and a B rush. Nobody's going for C though. Usually the American team goes for C, but not this match.
Well, as it looks like Super Mario is going to cap C with his M18. At least he's going that direction.
INVA the smashy gets blindsided on the side by a jumbo. And he's out.
The 109 shrine.
Alright.
Oh, and he gets it.
Super Mario's
going. Those rockets are hard to hit.
Yeah, I suck with rockets.
They're like, from the experience that I have with them, they like go into a 5% upwards angle when you fire them off. Quite annoying. But he handled them pretty nicely and killed the jumbo. Oh, and they spawned an M16.
Go, go, AA gun. It's a tough choice what to bring, the M16 with its quad 50s, or to bring out the M19 with two 40mm cannons.
Though I have to say, the M19 is, from the standpoint of just covering the air and killing stuff, is better. The M16 is more of a harasser. You can annoy people with the 50 cals.
Very true.
In this patch here, in 1.49, they're pretty much flamethrowers, so you have the potential to set an enemy afire, which is a nice thing.
Alright, both 109s have now landed and are rearming and repairing. Well, the ticket lead is still to INVA, but Weakenators holds two of the three objectives.
That's a sneaky position there from Leggy, man. He positioned himself behind one of those obstacles on the beach, and it's...
And he just knocked
unpenetratable.
Out. He just knocked out one of his crew members in his transmission.
I know, he's sitting behind that thing on purpose.
I know, but he drove forward too fast and knocked one of those guys out.
Oh, yeah. Is he still... The panther and the tiger are not able to kill him? They can't penetrate that obstacle?
You can't shoot through those out that particular obstacle.
That's quite sneaky.
He is keeping him distracted. Looks like he's trying to help out his help out Freedom Launcher, who is now getting a side shot on the panther.
Jumbo and the turret crew on the panther is out.
The Jumbo is just wrecking the panther right now.
Yep, that panther's down.
There we go. Now he has the side shot and above the tiger down on the beach. Tiger's turning.
Oh, let's still he's even pinned. Able to elevate the gun.
Gotta love that American gun depression.
That's glorious.
Two quick kills for Freedom Launcher.
No, it's only the 109s left. That's quite similar to what the situation in the last battle was.
Yep. It looks like we're going to be going to Berlin map. Because who won last match? Was it INVA?
It was the Weakenators, I think.
Oh. I can't remember.
I think so. Yeah, they were on the German side and the Germans had... no planes in the air, but there was two Corsairs.
I would like for INVA to win because there's a staff member on the Weakenators, Super Mario. He's a staff member. I want him to die. But it looks like they're gonna win this match.
Maybe they bump him.
But even if they bomb him, they still don't have the cap points.
Well, at least you have some. How do you say that?
They're coming. They're coming to drop
revenge.
Some freedom.
I like the English skills to say what I mean.
And he misses. Oh.
To be fair, this 250 kilo bomb is having a strange, well, physic when dropped and
he
okay,
misses.
Well, that bomb was
worse.
That bomb where that was off.
It looks like this is going to be end of the match here, ladies and gentlemen. I don't see INVA coming out of this.
They have a tiger that just spawned. But
and
I think it's not going to be enough.
They're being spawn camped by Super Mario. Keep your tiger angled.
And he penetrated them.
He's being shot by three M18s. That's not good for a tiger.
Yeah.
I see
That's
another.
That's the end of INVA.
Well, another one of this tiger. One of Commander's faults is he's bringing way too much ammo. The magic number is 25 to 23 rounds, so that way you don't have any ammo in your turret cheeks.
That's true.
It might have helped him, but
yeah.
Oh well.
Good battle, that's a win for the Weakenators. They're going to, and now I have to check the boards for it.
Weakenators won first round, and this round, so Weakenators advance.
We'll fight... Either the tap or fetch. Whatever team of them will lose in the quarterfinal that they're in.
Let me ask Zebra, who's. Are we doing a 302nd rematch next? But good game all around. Both teams did just fine.
Yep, they gave each other a good fight. So, Shall I ask Zerba, or?
Well, I just messaged him.
Oh,
he's
okay.
Typing to me right now. Okay, we're now switching over back to our original match of 302nd versus Wolfpack. I just need to switch to that server now. Okay, where's his name at?
Okay. Obelich is going to host the room for you as the information,
yep.
Cody.
I got the information.
The password is
I got it. I got
in
it.
The chat. Okay, you got it as well. Okay, fine.
Okay, let me plug in my headset. Alright, yeah, I'll take off my camera during the match if you guys want me to. No problem. Alright, place your bets. Which team you think is going to win? Let me see. Let me look at the mat. The contestants real quickly. My money is going to be on. I'll say 302nd. You may want to notify another group that 302nd still doesn't have the person already. I'm still in traffic. Alright, I'll tell them. Like I said, I don't know, we'll move the camera around. The people coming in noise. You mean the TeamSpeak noises? Yeah, I can try. Well, nobody's gonna be joining my channel anyway. See, a lot of love for the 302nd. We'll see what happens. Apparently, looks like we're still gonna go even with what we have. Looks like, because there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's 5 302nds and 7 wolf packs. So I might be doing a 5 versus 5 match here.
Oh, today seems to be the day of the 5 versus 5 battles.
Well, it's a Monday, so you know, not everybody's up to par. Nobody likes Mondays.
Luckily, it's already Tuesday where I'm living.
Yeah, I'm still stuck in Monday for a few more hours. See, so, yeah, it looks like, according to Zebra, who's the leader of the tournament, that we're still gonna go. They are just waiting for a guy who lost connection. What battle are these? They're using a mixture of tier 3 and I think it's tier 2 and tier 3 vehicles. It's on the website of what's allowed, what's not allowed.
Basically, like, gathered some vehicles that are good to go against each other. Like, for the Air Force, the Americans had to take carrier-based aircrafts, since there's only carriers where you can land, That's why the FRU-1D is the choice.
Yes, British tanks are coming, and yes, desert maps and snow maps are coming for tanks. I don't know when, though, but they will be coming soon. You know, soon, trademark.
Hey, apparently we're going to start.
That looks like it. Looks like Wolfpack is ready. I think 302nd's ready. At Wiz 25, show the dog, please. There you go. That's Coco. And then this white lump behind it.
Oh god. Another guy lost connection.
What?
Another guy lost connection.
Oh, for goodness sakes. I wouldn't expect the ships to come out until maybe next year. I don't know though, but that's just my personal guess, is next year. So what, apparently, well, Nolly's saying that we only have 5 members now, so what, did they have 6? Oh yeah, they did have, it was 6 versus 6, but they just lost the guy. Yeah, the vehicles are actually amazingly, pretty well even. You know, the Jumbo Sherman is a good match to fight and defeat the Tiger. You don't see very many German tank destroyers, though. Usually people bring a Panther and the Tigers.
It really is a shame. The Panzer 470 is really a bouncy vehicle in this tournament. There's some spots on the map where you can really use all the advantages that the vehicle provides.
Hello, Ditirka, how's it going?
You went out.
There you go, now you have 2 dogs to look at. Oh yeah, I want more maps too, Daddy's Toy. I know, I'm with you there.
Oh, 5 more minutes.
Sorry guys, we're just waiting. Let me change this text up. So I think that the majority of people who are talking mostly want to see 302nd. So because of that, I'm switching to Wolfpack. Just because I gotta go against you guys. And yes, there will be desert maps and everything. It'll be, you know, you'll have probably LL main and all that kind of stuff.
I remember something that is sitting in my ear right now, that's the British tanks are going to be introduced when the desert maps are coming.
Yep. They need winter maps though, because we already have winter camouflages in games. Who is my favorite in the tournament so far? I don't know many of the team. That's the problem. I don't know. I honestly don't know. That is true. There's lots of nice desert skins as well.
Okay, I'm going to go to Zerba for a second.
Alrighty, we'll be here.
User left your channel.
Sorry for the wait, ladies and gentlemen. There's nothing we can do. Do some magic tricks. I got nothing. I have dogs you can look at. That's about it, really. Yeah, if you at least enjoying the stream, feel free to follow my Twitch, my YouTube, my Facebook, my Twitter. I do Golden Eagle giveaways Monday and Wednesday at 5 p.m. Eastern. I already did my Golden Eagles giveaway today. Yeah, I'd like a Winter Stalingrad map. That would be awesome. The problem with tanks from Japan is that they don't really have anything that could compete at tier 3, 4, and 5. You know, Japan was mostly island hopping, so they didn't really need to bring any tanks. But I mean, if they made Japanese tanks, I'd play them. We're just waiting, everyone. Sorry. Dog bias. Look, if you like an ankle biter, or if you like a medium-sized dog, I have either one. Okay, well, it looks like we're starting in 60 seconds. Philip, I have no idea. I mean, jungle, I guess.
Cool, cool. Get up here.
Okay, it looks like it's going to be a 1, 2, it's going to be a 5 on 7 map, match. Yep, looks like we're going to have a 5 on 7 fight going.
User joined your channel.
Okay, that's that.
So it's going to be 5 or 7 now?
It's going to be a 5 versus 7.
Hmm. So already the odds are already in Wolfpack's favor.
Yeah, they like are allowed to join in progress, but the battle really needs to start now because there's other battles waiting just for this one. And so, well, do not hold the how do you call that? The time or anything or other battles. This needs to start now.
Yeah, because I think I have one more match I need to stream. And it's supposed to be... Well, the second match is supposed to start now.
Exactly. Okay. That's why we really need to start this now. Well, that's... What a Monday, basically.
Alright. Let's start this. Yeah, for those of you guys who are thinking a 3-0 second's gonna win, the odds are against them. It's 5 versus 7. Because we can't delay anymore. Unfortunately, you know, we've got to start. Alright, the battle is now starting.
Let's see what the teams are going to do.
Okay, I'm just gonna turn off my camera. That'll be easier. Alright, just waiting for people to spawn now. Yes, the American T-28 is in game.
And we see Wolfpack rolling out with one TBF.
Yeah, three planes, no AA guns on the Wolfpack side. 302nd, it's got an Ostwind.
And the BF-109, just for air superiority. That's There's... pretty risky.
I think he's just trying to stop them from bombing the initial bomb loads, you know? So three Tigers, an Ostwind, or Ostwind, and a 109. Versus two Corsairs.
Oh, what is the Ostwind doing?
He's shooting at that.
The Corsairs are coming on. This is... could go horribly wrong. Oh, there goes the first one. And...
Ooh, and...
Well, two Corsairs down. Now the TBF is coming in. The question, what is he going to do? He's bombing
going
one of
the
Tigers.
Tiger.
And... Bomb activation
Miss.
Time. Save the Tiger. The Osman is still peppering everything else but the TBF.
He even wants to get that Hellcat.
Now he's turning. Is he able to get him? Yes, yes. But the bombs are falling. Oh, bomb activation time is saving him once again.
Gotta turn off that activation time.
And we can see, look there. Little flat Panzer. Wolfpack keeps going for bombers of this battle.
And now the Hellcat is getting shot up by the Ostwind.
And he's hitting him.
He's done a lot of damage to him.
Oh, the 109 is going for a rampage on the TBS. Killed one. Failed the other one.
The other one looks like it's... The other one's
got... They give Wolfpack a really hard fight.
Yeah, the Wolfpack's TBF is damaged pretty heavily, but he's still flying.
And then another Corsair is coming in from Wolfpack right here. And the TBF is down.
He ripped his wings.
This is interesting. Who'd guess that the 302nd is actually giving them such a hard fight?
I think a little bit of overconfidence is what happened here. The other guy with the accent, he's from Germany. Okay, we have a Corsair
I'm
with
trying
rockets.
Trying my best to not sound too German.
You can't change the German sound.
Yes. He's on its tail, and he's peppering him pretty hard.
Ostwind versus Jumbo. Quite an odd fight. Thanks
There's
for following,
a chance
guys.
For the Ostwind to kill the Jumbo.
He keeps...
And he's aiming at the right position. He just now needs to gunner up.
Ah, I see. I think I see what the Jumbo's problem is. He's only brought APCR rounds. And he brought a lot of them.
And he got him.
He finally got him though, but he kept punching through the ammo, but he just couldn't get a detonation.
Now it's three Tigers from the 302nd, and there's a Corsair coming in with rockets.
Oh, he just took out three of the Tigers' crew members and set them on fire with one APCR round. He set them on fire a second time.
And the rockets hit the building.
They missed. Man, this is why you don't want to only bring APCR rounds, because they're only useful in some situations. I mean, granted, he is peppering the heck out of the Tiger, and he finally destroyed it, but...
That's a nice hit from the Corsair right there.
See, now we're getting to the point where, even though the 302nd was doing fairly well in the beginning, they're just running out of people.
Yeah. the problem for them. Well, they... You can say they try their best to keep up what they've started with in this battle.
They're trying their hardest. But is it enough?
Oh, J87 spawned.
Oh, and he's brought only the single bomb. Didn't want to bring the triple bombs.
Oh, that leaves it to one tank on the ground. If they lose, no, it's not enough. The Wolfpack kept this.
The Panther's gun breach is gone. Now it's totally broken.
And the battle is over. It was first round for Wolfpack right here.
Good job, Wolfpack.
Oh, that's so sad for this 302nd. They could have probably won that round there if they had 7 guys.
You gotta give them an A for effort. But that was a good game. But they're still up to 2 more matches.
Where are they going? Someone just left the battle.
Yeah, they did. What the heck is going on here? Well, that too, Philip. Don't shoot the same spot over and over with APCR rounds. Okay, we're trying to get them to switch teams and nations.
Wait, I'm asking Zerbra.
Oh. Apparently, did they have a match without us?
Well, that is what I'm confused about.
We were supposed to stream both
Zerba's
matches.
Zerbra's already asking. I'm confused right now. They really had a different battle? Checking that.
User left your channel.
Huh. Apparently Wolfpack has won. Apparently they did a match without us.
User joined
well,
your channel.
Yeah, it was the second round, apparently.
Okay.
Although we've seen one.
Okay, so now to our second match now? Our third match, technically. Okay, well, apparently that's all for 302nd Wolfpack. Apparently Wolfpack won a match that we didn't see. Okay, so, Copstrider, are we going to the next match now?
I think so. They just need to open a battle for that. I'm not sure if one is open right now.
Alright, now it's DNW versus 221B.
This leaves me confused. They really had a battle?
Yeah, I don't know. Well, then one of the guys that were missing, he just arrived, apparently, according to my team's, or according to my Twitch. I don't know. I'm going to assume we're going to our next match, then.
I'm going to ask Zerba again if the battle's right. Already open.
Here, just ask him to come down here and let us know what's going on.
Okay.
Because people on the stream
well.
Are as confused as I am.
Well, yeah, understandably.
User left your channel.
Hold on, guys. We're getting confirmation right now.
User joined
okay.
your channel.
No, he knows.
Alright, is he gonna hop down here?
Yeah, he's going to come.
Okay.
Just going to finish the conversation that he has with the Wolfpack guys.
User
and then...
joined your channel.
There he is.
Hello, guys.
Hey, Zebra, what's going on?
Yeah, we are now going to host the match. Well, Aldelich is going to host the match between RFBR and, well, DNW RFBR and. 221st Baker's THP. Okay?
Alright.
You just stay put and we will get the guys there as soon as possible.
Alright, hold on. I need to find the match again. So apparently Wolfpack won a match that we didn't see?
Yeah, they had round while you were streaming the other match. So,
okay.
Yeah, they won 2-0.
Alright, we just wanted to confirm.
Yeah, sorry, it's kind of a little bit mixed up of a mix-up today because one match was delayed because players couldn't come in time and the other match started late, so yeah, it was kind of a overlap.
Alright, we're in the next match.
Okay.
User left your channel.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, pick your teams. We have the Brazilian team of DNW / RFBR versus the Chinese team 221B / THP.
Which is a pretty long name for a squad.
Yeah, well, we've got technically four squads competing in this match. Alright, I will let you entertain the crowd for a moment. I need to go get a beverage.
Whoa, go ahead.
So I shall return in one moment. And it's not Brazil versus Russia, it's Brazil versus China.
They even have a guy from Australia in their team.
Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that.
Oh, no problem. I was very successful in not saying anything.
Yeah, I heard that. You're such a great commentary.
Thank you.
Okay, everyone, pick your team. Brazil versus China. Sit. Good boy. Alright, the teams are piling into the server. We should be starting momentarily. So I'm seeing some love for Brazil, I'm seeing some love for China. The crowd seems to be split.
Well, Cody, you're still in the same lobby?
Yep.
Okay. I thought it's going to be a different lobby, so I decided to leave it.
No, yeah, I left it and rejoined. Because I'm smart.
Well, I think this is going to be a proper 7v7 battle this time.
Yeah, it's hopefully we'll get lots of good competition here. I'm gonna advertise a little bit in War Thunder's channel chat.
Was it DNW slash RFBR versus 221B slash THP? Yeah, I would like to see the Chinese win this. I think it would be very interesting. They're the first ever Chinese clan that's in a tournament for War Thunder. So they've got to represent China.
Hey. Battle is going to start in 3 minutes.
Alrighty, let me get it updated.
Well, at least Obelich is hoping that the battle is going to start in 3 minutes.
That'll probably be 5 minutes. I don't know if this is gonna lag that bad. Well, it depends where the server's hosted at. I'm guessing it's in Europe. Because if you have Brazil, and then China. No, well, it could be an ocean server. That would be in between them. I don't know. I'm gonna probably lag, though. Alright. I see some people wanting to see Sweden for some reason. The 302nd lost, GOAT. Alright. See some more. Yeah, I would like to see China win as well. Okay, hold on. This guy can get banned from chat real quick. Get out the ban hammer. Yeah, sometimes you gotta ban the trolls.
As it appears, we're going to start in a few seconds.
Okay, sweet.
Yeah, everybody is ready. It's just Obelich that needs to start the battle for now.
Let's get this show on the road. Yeah, I'm voting for China too. Go 221.
Yep, there we go. we finally start.
All
and
right.
I was 25 minutes delayed to this battle.
What are you talking about? Everything's going perfectly. There's nothing wrong. I just had to ban somebody because they were being naughty in general chat. It happens.
Evil.
Be good.
Okay, everybody's on the right team. DHP slash the 221st on the American side. RFBR slash DNW on the Germans.
Alright, bringing out the German flak truck instead of the Austin. A risky
That's
move.
Interesting. And two BF-109s. Okay, meanwhile, oh!
Lots of Corsairs coming out.
DHP going with Corsairs. The flak truck has a very low fire rate in comparison to the Osman, which normal most of the teams are using. So.
And he's also only brought one ammo belt for the Osman, which is or the, for the flak truck, which is probably a mix. Nope, it's high explosive only.
And he
killed
gets the
a
first
kill.
Guy. That was a good shot. And no, he missed that one.
Got,
and he killed another one.
Guy.
Wow, he's a good shot. Now it's only two of the Corsairs left that started the attack initially, although they killed two guys of the... No, I'm sorry, that was the wrong team that I looked at. Everyone of the... One of the RFBR guys know that. So... But I think that was a bad trade-off. Three people dying in comparison to one tank that is...
Ooh, and another
four.
Corsair.
Every Corsair down. For THP right here.
That is what you want on your team, ladies and gentlemen. You want a guy who is good at the AA.
Okay, I'm not. I was assuming that the AA is not going to have a good time against for Corsairs, especially since it's slow firing.
What the Corsairs should have done is they should have tried to knock out the AA first and then gone for their tanks.
They weren't communicating with each other. They were just pummeling in one after another.
Alright, well now the 221B has brought out an AA gun. To try to even the playing
field. Just in the
right
situation. Since RFBR decided to go for multiple airplanes right here. Even the J87, which is coming in. Which is pretty bad, to be honest, in this kind of lineup. Because every single tank on the American side has a 50 cal. Which was able to penetrate or completely kill the J087.
Well, I've noticed not many people actually use their 50 cals on their Shermans to go for AA defense. So very rare does it happen in this tournament for whatever reason.
They really should do that because it's really
it's
strong.
Very effective.
It's something that also some people underestimate that. AA vehicles, especially now the flak truck, they're very easy to destroy with machine guns. And I see a lot of people just shooting at AA vehicles rather than using the 50 cals to pepper it.
Now we have an odd match forming here. We've got a large amount of tanks on the beach actually fighting.
That
two.
Was a very good hit by, I think, Caio Hartmann there. He killed the N19 just with his main armament on his BF-109.
I got two jumbos versus a tiger and a panther on the beach. Actually, three jumbos versus a tiger and a panther now. And the one jumbo is laying into both
oh!
of them.
Oh! He ripped his wing on one of the cables.
The balloons have claimed another victim.
Those cheeky balloons on this map. Huh? There goes the flak truck, which did a remarkably good job in this battle.
He did his job in this match.
So THP camping the spawn as it appears. With two vehicles.
221B slash THP is in the lead currently.
Yeah, they hold two caps and RFBR is coming with two Stukas now.
We'll
trying
see if,
to get some victims.
See if the Stukas can level the playing field here.
Let's see if they are able to do it.
Stukas are four clicks out.
Now THP capping the last and third cap on this map.
Now let's see if any of these Shermans start using their 50 cals on these Stukas. If they would, they'd be able to put up a pretty decent AA field of fire.
Just a question if they actually binded the red keys and realized that they are having MGs from there.
Alright, well, looks like Mr. Jovian is about to bomb B.
And they do. They use their 50 cals. And he pilot sniped them.
GG. Let's see
no
what the
challenge
second
are coming
season.
In. Let's see if someone says peppering. Yes. Lonely Wolf is opening fire with MG as well.
And he missed his lineup, so he's going to turn all the way around, giving them plenty of opportunities to shoot at him.
PHP making good use of everything that they got on the field.
Alright, here comes the Stuka. There's two tanks really close to each other. Bombs out.
Bomb activation time once again.
A time delay.
Wow, he's a...
That's a long delay. There they go.
Wow, he's going for the 10-second delay.
I think that's too risky for this.
That is, I think, not really working for him. I mean, the bomb itself was quite on target, but the bomb delay made it...
Okay, well, they're still together in this... field. He drops the bomb.
If they move, then that's out.
He might get one.
No, they're
nope,
moving away.
Not. They're running. You can't bring those 10-second delays, especially in a match like this. Now the Stuka is driving around or flying around, giving fire with his 20mm cannons. Looks like he has air target rounds though, and he broke his wings on a tree, but they're still attached, but they're black. Can he get it back to base?
Well, he's the last survivor, and THP won the first battle by capping.
Go China. All right. That was a pretty decent first match. China coming off with the first victory. Now let's see if they can do that in German vehicles. All right, 3 minutes. Until the match is ready. So feel free, stretch your legs, use the restroom, get a drink. Follow me on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Twitch. Feel free to. No, you can delay your bombs in this. But I would not recommend it during these tournaments. And then
for my experience, like 1 second bomb delay, I think is enough to safely get out of the position when you're that low and dropping your bomb. But 10 seconds is. It's
heck, I even do a 0.5 second delay.
Yeah. If it's then still working, then it's fine, but if it's 10 seconds, I mean, everything is... Even the mouse is able to drive out of a bomb that is having a 10-second delay.
Now let's see if both teams have learned that bomb delays are bad, bringing a guy who's good at AA is a good thing. Let's see if they can keep those in mind. That was some fine AAA shooting from that guy. Reminds me of me. Wiz is a super serious bomb master. Well, you know, I mean, I put many hours in War Thunder, let me tell ya. Yeah, you guys, at least in my chat, you guys can feel free to cheer for your teams and stuff like that. You can speak Chinese or Brazilian, I don't care. You know, celebrate your nationality and celebrate the teams that are competing. They're fighting for their glory and yours. I'm sitting here doing my crew points. Yeah, I feel like each team, when they start off, if it's 7-on-7, at least have one bomber, one AA gun, and then I think everything else is kind of whatever you choose. What's my favorite German tank? Oh, I gotta go with the Tiger tanks. I love the Tigers. Especially the H1 and the E, and also the Porsche Tiger, the premium one. If you know how to angle your armor, and you know your strengths and weaknesses, you can do very well. There are AI AT guns on certain maps, like Kursk. Okay, we've got about 30 seconds until the match begins. Yeah, I like the Yag Panther as well. Is there any real advantages to long delay besides getting out of the way? No. I mean, you could carpet bomb an area, let people drive over it, and then blow them up. But, I don't remember who won both matches last night, unfortunately. But it's time to start. I think that's the correct overlay. I think they're gonna swap. Well, I always say, Porsche Tiger, best Tiger.
He's looking a bit odd.
Alright, let's see who is going to win. Oh good, I actually did it right.
There it is, 1-19 for RFBR, and 3 Corsairs.
And they see...
PHP is doing the similar thing. They have three planes and one Osman.
But they're bringing... Oddly enough, the Germans are not bringing any Tigers out first. They're going with the more mobile Panthers. You can angle it slightly Tiger for life. Just a little bit. Not too much. So this is something we have not seen before, where no Tiger 1s are being brought out at first. Is this a good thing, or is this a mistake? We'll soon find out.
Oh, there's a lot of people going for the C-Cap from RFBR. There's...
Okay.
Two M18s sitting comes, there, and the M19 is rolling there as well.
Here comes the first bomb run. He lets off. And...
That was a miss.
He got nothing. Maybe some damage, but no kills.
It did some damage to the vehicle, but only the cannon. Oh.
Okay, now we're having us an air-to-air combat now.
Oh. One of the RFBR guys successfully killed the Ostwin.
Ostwin down! Ostwin down!
And he died as well. What's the question? Oh, there's another way. Oh, that's the other crosshair down. Okay, right. that's the air force of RFBR right there. No THB having still bombs attached on two of their planes. They're trying to.
Okay, the fight for the center of the map is about to begin. Already had a little bit of skirmishing. One jumbo is severely damaged in the middle.
One,
but another one
just right.
Gets a flank on a Panther. Cripples him.
And gets bombed in return.
Oh.
Another trade-off. There's a lot of trade-offs happening in this tournament where people bomb the tank and then instantly crash or get shot down.
I think both teams are out for blood this match. Alright, all's quiet in the actual town. There's only two tanks in the town. 109 G6 is coming in to bomb A. Instead, his buddy, the Panther,
and he crashed.
Gets the kill and he wrecks.
Every one of them is just crashing.
Alright, looks like everyone's aircraft is out for the count. And the first Tiger is finally on the field after almost 5 minutes.
Together with six Panther A's. Which seem to be the preferable vehicle for the Chinese.
Well, they're very fast, maneuverable. They have the choice of Panzergranat or APCR rounds, if they have them.
Another one of the RFBR guys down.
Well, that's an odd thing. Challenger on the Brazilian team just jumped out of his AA gun, wasting his life to jump into something else. Out of a perfectly good AA gun.
I think it's needed
on
the field. Looking at that they only have three players with vehicles left.
Alright, well, Challenger jumped out of the AA gun and brings out a Corsair with rockets.
Well, they are able to turn the table, but it comes down to the Corsairs hitting every single rocket. That's the thing that they need to do.
Bad angle. Breaks off the attack.
Let's see if he's still going for it.
Looks like Guilty Spark
and
is knocked out.
That was the first rocket attack that was successful.
Surprised these Panthers are not using their machine guns to try to knock out these Corsairs before they rocket them to death.
Oh, that was not
Challenger
good.
hits a barrage balloon.
And the that's two down, two Corsairs down, only one remaining with four rockets. Actually, two of the Corsairs crashed into barrage balloons there.
Oh, I only saw one. Okay, he's making the line on AAA.
I think the other guy that I did observe.
Ooh, his wing is shot off by the Panther.
That was a good hit of that Panther.
Nice shot.
I think this is the win for THP here, with only one vehicle remaining for RFBR, and the fact that they're holding two of the captures.
We'll see what he does. Maybe he can pull out a miracle. He's facing off with a Tiger. He overpens the Tiger and gets his own engine caught on fire, or his transmission, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
And he's dead. He's down.
Well, that was a good fight from RFBR, but THP came up with, well...
And that, ladies and gentlemen, I think will be the end of the match.
Yeah. That's 2-0 for THP, which will advance one step in the loser bracket for the American tournament. Sadly for RFBR, this is the top for their, well, tournament, at least for this one.
A well-fought match. Congratulations to all the winners today. Alright, I think that's all of the matches that are streamed today, is it not?
I think so. There's still AGN sitting there in room 4 on the official TeamSpeak here.
Yeah, but I'm not sure if I'm streaming that match. I think Zebra is. I don't know. We'll see what happens. We'll see if I have another match to stream. I'm asking right now. So hold on, ladies and gentlemen, we're finding out if that is the end of today's matches. Oh, if there's one more, I'm not sure. I'm waiting for Zebra to come back and let me know. Yeah. The Chinese definitely dominated that last match, even getting a Panther to snipe a Corsair out of the sky. It's always nice to be able to do that. You feel so accomplished when you manage to do that, especially at long range.
Has Zerba answered yet?
No, he hasn't. He's in the AFK channel. I think he actually is AFK.
I'm not sure.
I don't want to end the stream unless it's actually the end.
They like sitting on this kind of channel.
Okay, he's typing. Hold on. Yep, that's all.
Okay, well then. It was some interesting battles today.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for hanging out. Hopefully you enjoyed. I think we have more matches tomorrow, correct?
Yeah, we have on the European, and we have on the American server as well.
Okay, awesome.
I'm going to play.
You're going to be playing? I hope you die.
Yeah.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, hopefully you guys enjoyed. The next brackets will continue tomorrow, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Break that down into whatever time zone you use. Yeah, the previous matches are uploaded to my YouTube channel, and they're also on my videos on demand on my Twitch page. If you enjoyed, make sure that you are following me on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Twitch. And hopefully you guys enjoyed. We'll be back tomorrow with even more matches. Until then, this is Wiz25 and Cop Schroeder saying adios. So we'll see you guys later. Thanks for hanging out.